All right, the time has come. Y'all want to know how much it costs to race, or do you want to know how much it costs a-flem to race the Fighting Falcon? Ooh, that's one. All right, we're back. We're gonna go ahead and finally give y'all the semi price breakdown, because I say semi because you can't drive, you can't buy driving skills, nothing too major. So we're gonna go ahead and start off, and I paid $10,000 for this car.
Yeah, right.
So we'll let Skyler start, because y'all know a-flem just drives them. I don't buy them, or we work on them, but I don't buy them. So, oh,
you, man. You build them.
That ain't no good. So let's go ahead and get it. So let's start.
What's up, everybody? So we're here with the Fighting Falcon, and we're going to do a price reveal, price breakdown on how much it costs for us to build this.
They want to know, what if they want to race? What if they want to build a Fighting Falcon?
Won't never happen.
It can only be one of one. But what can they do? What do they need to start with?
So here's how we did it. A lot of people always ask us, like we've already mentioned, how much does it cost you guys to race? Like, if I wanted to get into racing, what does it cost?
Well, but they want to build one of these. Let's go on just
this. So this is a 2002 RSX Type S. The first thing and first step to do is be on the lookout for them. They're very slim to find these type of cars, even though we have had a lot of success at buying them. But what you do, you go on Facebook Marketplace, Craigslist, driving around, seeing them in the back of people's yards, immediately stop. That's what me and Travis like to do. But you find one and you go from there. And so what you do is, once you get it, depending on the shape of the car, you start parting it out. And the thing is with some of these cars, different ones that you can drive, Hondas, Dodge, Neons, RSX, Civics, Sunfires, Cavaliers, all of them have a different market for the parts that are on it. Some people or some cars generally have a lot higher part outs than most. Like, for instance, if you find one that's an old rare car that not a lot of people have, or it's not something that people restore, especially not an import like a Dodge Neon or something like that, or a Pontiac Sunfire, no one really cares to have them parts because they're not really highly sought after. But like Honda Civics, RSX, Integras, things like that, that people are trying to restore back to like Rice Rocket.
Fast and the Furious. Regular Honda Civic?
Regular Honda Civics are the same. But a lot of different cars have different price values when it comes to the part outs. But these RSX Type S and the base models are very highly sought after cars to be daily drivers. So these are really good at making money back on the part out. So what we'll do is, this car we purchased originally for $1,700. And Dad, y'all saw in a video when we started building Austin's car, Dad actually drove this car home. So that lets you know the condition right there, that Dad was able to actually get this. We went and picked it up from a lady and he drove it home. So pretty much was complete minus a few things. It had a busted headlight. What else did it have? It had an issue with some interior.
The front right fenders were busted.
The left front fender. So the condition was mediocre. It wasn't amazing, but it could have been able to be driven
on
the street.
Up here was messed up a little.
Yeah, the top. Well, no.
But let me ask you something. Yeah. So $1,700 is what you got this one.
That's right. We bought it for $1,700.
So let me ask for them. That's not the typical price you would get one driving for, correct?
That's right. So there's ways to get really good deals. These cars usually range, for the condition that it was in, between about $3,000 and $5,000.
Okay.
That's your typical price range. But depending on who you buy from, the condition of the car, you can get them
for cheaper. Seller and buyer.
Seller buyer. Yeah, if you're a good buyer and you can talk them down a little bit, you know, you do have the chance to get them for cheaper like we did. But
so what would be a price that if somebody had one driving, no knocking the motor, I mean, like this one, maybe some cosmetic, if someone says, I want this much, they should be seriously interested. Anything under $2,000 for sure, right?
Absolutely. If you find one of these that's under $2,000 and you want to make it a race car, you need to buy it.
Title or no title?
Title or no title. It doesn't matter. If you want it to be a race car, not
checked,
a daily driver.
We checked with somebody to see if it was stolen.
But
we
this car on. Did come with a title. So it was a clean title and we got that. Obviously, you don't need any more. But the first thing we did is we immediately started cutting parts off. We cut off cat converters. We took out headlights, and all the complete interior airbags.
Let's look at that.
Yeah, so we took out, pretty much all of it.
So everything's out, so all right.
So a few of the hot items that you immediately want to get rid of are the catalytic converter. The seats on these cars are amazing, or if you have good seats and they're in good condition. The seats are amazing, the tail lights, headlights, the airbags, the dash, any of the interior pieces on these cars are very highly sought after. So that's what we did. So right off the bat, you can usually catalytic converters, if you get them and they're good, go anywhere between 200 to all the way up to 800. So we sold the catalytic converter, we sold the interior, completely got rid of it, got rid of all the airbags, got rid of the glass, all the side glasses and the front glasses, the door cards, steering wheel airbag. As you can see here, Austin's is gone. These steering wheels, they do sell good, but no one's bought it yet. We got rid of all the dash pieces and we kept the harness and the cluster. But pretty much majority of all the parts, when we sold everything, we, I think, ended up getting right at about, I think it was $1,100. Or $1,200 for everything. No, it wasn't that much.
I thought it was more.
Yeah, it was way more than that.
The problem is you constantly are selling stuff.
That's right.
Stuff.
So we're constantly selling stuff, but let's back up because I don't want to tell the full price because I want to do that at the end. That's the thing. You sell the stuff, and I'll tell you all the price at the end because let's talk about what we had to buy.
You completely gut it.
Sell everything off. And so what
keep
we had
engine,
to buy.
Engine, transmission, rims. And the wing, you gotta keep the wing.
But what we had to buy, another one of the things is this back hatch. I sold the whole entire back hatch, glass, trunk, and all, and we got one that was damaged.
Oh,
so
I have something
cut it off.
You didn't mention.
What's that?
A lot of times you can trade people for damaged ones.
Yeah, that's
what
I do.
There.
I usually trade off damaged ones for good ones. But what we had to buy to race, this is something that you're gonna have to buy no matter what. We'll talk about the price of that. Obviously, the cage. $550. So that's a Larry Dickinson cage.
Plus the metal in there.
Yep. $550 for that. We had to buy, of course, the Wendonette and the system, which was about $85. Austin bought brand new seat belts, which are about $85. We already had the seat. So if you have to buy a seat,
they go for?
It's about $150 to $200 for the non-containment.
That's without the cushion because a lot of times the cushion's the same price.
We had to buy tires, which were what, $300?
These tires are
waterfalls
off eBay. They're about $237. Let's just say $230 for a set of four.
Then we had to
buy
the metal. So to get the metal, you don't have to do the metal, but we bought the metal. I think that's roughly about $100 for all the metal.
Bought it all for all our cars.
Yeah, we bought a whole roll to do all cars. And then, of course, walk up here. We had to buy hood.
These right here, which I'm just saying, it's funny. You can get these safety. Harbor Freight for like $5 or $6.
Yep. So, Austin, see, now you tell them.
I'm just hitting. I'm probably out of order. Schuyler orders the numbers.
Yep.
The paint, this paint was spray painted.
From Walmart. 97 cent duplicate.
No, it was the $3, which they just restocked. Y'all saw in the previous video, Schuyler sprayed the 13, which we're going to do. But with this only making two or three races, we just figured that was it. Which, see, now you see.
The stickers.
That we have to. But the stickers, Schuyler gets made from somewhere local. They're about, I think.
Gulf Coast Graphics.
About $100
for what I got. $150 for everything. Yeah.
And that came with some stickers and stuff.
But overall, once you get everything done, and then of course the big thing that we forgot to tell them is you can cut, when you cut and get any of the metal off,
you can scrap it. I did scrap it.
Right.
See,
we have a scrap trailer sitting out there. We also sold the AC compressor. Had to buy a new alternator for this one.
This compressor.
I sold one, didn't I, off of another car.
Another thing that you have to a lot of times check that I had to buy. So you can get.
He had to buy a new alternator.
Alternator was I can tell you eBay for these. You ain't gotta have name brand. You go on eBay, and I think I bought it for
$60, wasn't it?
It was under $100. We got lucky in the battery.
Battery was good in it still.
I just recently figured out, I don't know where everybody's from, that Costco has a really good deal on batteries. It's
really?
$60 a year, but they have good batteries on tires. But you can't beat just a waterfall tire off eBay.
Right.
This is my cold air intake system people think I have.
Stock air box.
So,
but pretty much.
Radiator?
Did you have to buy a radiator?
No, but you buy them on eBay and stuff.
Like $80.
You can get them all the way down to $53.
$53.
But you have to wait.
That's awesome. So overall, guys.
$12 for the hood pin little kid on eBay.
So overall, after selling everything, because I said it was $1,200, but I was wrong because I had to account for the trades and stuff that we did.
Don't tell them yet.
About what?
Another thing you gotta have.
What is it?
Very important. That's a big chunk of money. For the first time, you gotta have a racing suit.
Oh yeah, racing suit.
Brace.
Helmets.
Helmets. I would say shoes, which some people don't wear.
Or you get some Hey Dudes.
If you've watched recently.
Tyler Carpenter
I guarantee you, Hey Dudes is about to come out with a racing shoe. I guarantee it. So that's going to be, I bought my neck brace the same day, but you can get them for about $30 on Amazon. A suit, Amazon has a deal right now for $100, but that's not the kind me and Scott have. But if you're first starting, gloves. Most of your work gloves from Lowe's and all are fire retardant. People don't know this.
Yeah, you can use them.
So I got my gloves for $10 at Dollar General the night before the same night as the King of the Sandbox. Who was that? Oh, that's me. I'm King.
King Austin.
These right here, Skyler will tell you, these are really the race receiver is about $100.
Yeah, I mean, but you can, starting off, you can
you
pretty much,
a lot of
not
stuff,
all though. The tracks run with race receivers, but
well,
if your track
have,
does, you have to have one.
So some good suit, so you're looking at add another
$500 probably.
Suit for 100, let's just say, 130. Helmet.
You can get a helmet for 85 to 120.
On Amazon. So
yep.
You got to add another 300 just for safety equipment.
Right.
So
total, here you go. So total, this car, not counting any of our racing equipment, because we already had all that from our previous
car. You might already have that.
Talking about just the 00, it after parting everything else, catalytic converters, headlights, interior, seats, everything, for what we paid, $1,700 for this, we made $100. Yeah.
Not including win money.
Win. And if you include the two races that Austin's been throwing out, he's already made double what we paid for the car. So there you go. The Fighting Falcon 00 cost us a profit of $100 to build.
$90. Because I put, y'all know from the last race, I had to buy $10 of Bondo underneath here to try to help the wing.
So that's our experience with this car. Of course, all of these cars are going to be different. We're not telling you that you can make money to build a race car, but because even though we spent the $500 on the cage and all the window nets and all the things that you are required to have, the metal, everything, we still came out $100 ahead to build this car. And then Austin went out the first race and possibly won. What was that, $500 or $400?
$500. It was $350.
The first race that he got disqualified.
I don't know. My question for them is they don't – you could have probably made more. I want to talk real quick about – there's cheaper cages. Well, no, you're going to answer
this. Oh, yeah.
There's cheaper cages out there, right?
You can go All-Star and buy a – just a basic four-point cage for, I think, $250.
So why do we go with these?
The reason we go with Larry Dickinson cages is one.
Larry Dickinson. Where can they find that at?
I'll post the link down below, and y'all can go check him out. but Larry builds custom cages for this car. So instead of just getting a standard cage that just goes into any car, which is totally fine as long as you get it welded in right, we chose to go with these because they're all built specifically for these cars.
See how close this is.
I mean, you can see how everything just fits really nice and goes in really close to the doors.
Another thing.
That's the reason why.
Back in the old days, I've showed y'all some of the paint here, is cages that are already made. You notice we don't have anything cut here.
That's right. That's
we didn't have to cut, you know, our top off. And
right. Usually whenever you do that.
Have you ever done that?
Yeah. But before we started doing the RSX, Travis's car did get the top cut off. But before that, we would cut all these pillars right here, take the
drop
top
the
off,
cage.
Drop a cage that maybe was already prefabbed in, then weld the cage. But you can see we didn't take these tops off at all. So that's one of the reasons. But
so let me ask you this.
Yeah.
Let's say they couldn't find one for, they can't get lucky. We've made bad deals before.
We have.
I think you just said you got to eat while ago on some money. But bad deals. Let's say they had to pay $3,000 for one.
Yes. So if you pay $3,000 for a car.
Could you do the math and see what could they get a generic Fighting Falcon for?
So I'm going to say this, guys. If you find an RSX Type S for $3,000 that's 100% complete.
Drivable.
Cut. Drivable. They've got it on the track. You can probably, I'm going to say, easily make close to $2,000 in return off a part out to them cars.
That's without even making it a race car.
Without making it a race car. That's if you have good rims, good bumpers, good fenders, good interior, no glass is busted, and the seats are in great shape, and all the interior, engine, exhaust, everything is stock, you could probably make upwards to $2,000, and you'd have $1,000 left. And then you'd have to take, obviously, and buy all the safety equipment in the car. So I'm going to say that there's a potential that you could buy like a Dodge Neon or a Honda Civic for a couple of hundred, you know, $500-$600 and have a race ready car to hit the track for under $1,500.
Because I don't want to necessarily say that these are the only cars that win, because we've been beaten multiple times by, well, not a Dodge. I ain't seen a Dodge Neon in a while, but
Saturn.
I think what you're trying to say is for part out purposes, these seem to make a lot more.
These cars are the way to go.
So for under $5,000, they can make a fast car.
Absolutely.
Regardless. But if they want to make more on their return,
right.
Acura or Honda Civic or something.
You can ask any of the subscribers or the viewers now who are racing Type S or base models. If they did do a part out, they could confirm, oh yeah, I sold this for that, this for that, this for that. But
and I hate to say again that, you know, they say if you say this, you are. This is a complete stock. But for other places that allow motor work,
yep, SCDRA,
they have a lot more for this type of car. Then I don't know how much racing products they make for a Dodge Neons. I'm sure somebody does, but probably not as much as these.
Yeah, that's right. They've got a lot of parts that you can see. Obviously, with our Max speeding rods, they just sent us parts for these
and then
cars
you're looking,
that are specifically
you're
for
looking
races.
At about $250 to get your GoPro going and how much to start a little YouTube channel.
YouTube channel's free. As long as you got an iPhone and a computer, you can upload it. But that's pretty much it. As far as everything else goes, I mean, we hope that y'all see that it's not too bad. You do absolutely need to have a good buddy to help you. Don't do it by yourself. Yeah, a canine. Your family, anybody who wants to help you on these, because it's not fun to do it by yourself, but we encourage you guys, go get you a race car, go find your old cheap car, a beater, part it out, see how much you can do, and then let us know in the comments down below if you have built one of these cars, or any of you guys that are racing front wheel drives or any type of race car, let us know usually what you spend on yours or what you can part your stuff out. But that's all I got to say. I mean, $100 profit is what we made on this one with our part out. And Austin's got, what, 3 wins in it this year?
Yeah, we've probably lost money on pit pass and such.
Yeah, absolutely. You got anything else you want to say to sign
gonna,
out?
We're going to get a quick look.
Yeah.
Y'all check out Dirt Track Mafia. It's got a little paint. This one's getting ready to, oh, yeah. Let's see who's...
Travis calling.
Calling here.
Hey, bud.
Hey, bud.
Hey, you're on the YouTube channel.
Oh, hey, everybody. What's going on?
We just talked to him and told him that pretty much what we did is we made $100 profit on this build.
Pretty much. So after cage, cat, seats, interior, glove box, yeah, we actually came out. Now, I'm sure, you know, like calculating, we probably, some of the window net, things like that, once you add it all up, it'll probably, we probably broke even, basically.
Pretty much broke even.
We had a car.
That's right. So, well, we just are in and...
Did you explain to everyone all the processes of the best way to flip things, where to flip things?
No, we didn't tell them. We told them the best way to find them is just to go on, like, Facebook Marketplace and stuff, but I'm pretty much, you know, you can just part them out, put them on Marketplace, say you've got a car to part out, things like that, and go from there.
Yep.
But anyway.
So, let me show them real quick. Can you see on my camera?
Yeah.
Okay. So, the biggest thing is, like, for instance, RSX Type S, eBay. This is one thing that I would tell people to do. So, go to RSX Type S or type in the car that you have, and then come down and go down to buying format. Let's see. Hang on. No, that's not it. Just a second. Show. Here it is. Show only sold items.
Right.
So then you can come in here and you can see exactly the items that have been sold for your car.
So that way you can pretty much figure out the pricing and stuff.
This is a good way to price things out. So not only is this a good way to price things out, this is a good way to see what you would want to sell in person and on Marketplace and what you would want to sell in on eBay. So the other thing you should probably do is, because these are new parts as well, you go to sold items, but then you just come down and you go to condition and go to used.
Perfect.
So this lets you see all the used items. So for instance, if you're wanting to sell a steering column, $35, it was sold on eBay, not what it was listed for.
Right.
$48 for a silver handle. So not only does this give you an idea for what you could sell on eBay, but I tend to take about 60 to 70% of the value of eBay prices to sell something local.
Right.
One, because you don't have to deal with shipping prices. And two is, on the used market, eBay tends to be a little, just a hair on the high side. So if you're looking to sell parts, again, eBay, just to generally price something out, if someone says, hey, what do you want for the door handle? You go RSX Type S.
$48. Oh, a-flem just found a door handle.
Yeah, I got one.
Look at this. $48 right there.
It's broke. Can we bond on that?
Yeah. Well, Travis, we were just signing off. Do you have any last words for everybody? We told them, man, get you a car and do it. Build you one. Just do it. That's awesome. All right, dude. Well, we'll holler at you later.
All right, buddy.
Bye.
All right.
All right, guys. Well, that's it. You heard it from the bank. Go to eBay. Austin's got $48 in junk laying over there.
There you have it. $100 is what it costs us to build the Fighting Falcon. And no, she's not for sale. But we appreciate you guys watching. And speaking of new builds and part outs, we got another one.